can create many type of application with Visual C++, like
stream it,
win console application, and
but we need to this is what really has to be done. It's there's a lot to be done if you want to do this. It's not that hard. First, you need like the Node.js Twitch bot, and you need to know about IRC. I think I didn't mention. Maybe RC mIRC, and what's the other one? Oh yeah, Node.js and maybe Python. Again, so there maybe it's just like an inception of things. I had this Twitch bot. Again, I'm gonna have to something like expose Twitch IDs like I did last time in order to get all of this to work. But first things first, you need a WordPress. So then if you're adding media, you can quickly add something into the mix, so that the loot will be taxi driver. Yeah, I don't think he's a default character, so he could be the loot. So what you do is you could select this variable out later. That will become the loot. Oh, there's some SQL problems. So you'll create a database. And the insert statement. Just get to the main thing. Create database. There's more to that, but okay. I'm just trying to have it done. That's the minimum. Yeah, it could be different. This should be actually probably not. So this, that won't be part of it. That autos, this autos. No. So, and it's loot name, stay loot name. Picture can be this. And we'll just use a Steam ID for this, or a Twitch name. For example, so we did it. I did everything. Sometimes. This is the proper way to do it because now I have to cut to the beast. So is there anybody else in chat? I was trying to do pop-up chat and do this right. Oh yeah, I'm in the IRC. How do I connect to Twitch? Oh crap, I need to do some sort of mechanical work. Do I have it set up? Hell no. I have nothing set up here. That's bad. And most of this is just going to be IRC setup. Should I just make a new Twitch account? Probably. That one gets trashed, no one cares. So, PM hack bot one. Can we have dashes? This is okay, fine. We'll still persist in having spaces because having the word password in it is a violation of the law, but it lets me do it. It's April 23rd, 1985. Back to the future. Should have a privacy thing for this. Oh well. This is so, such an important thing to do for this. Oh. Okay. Anyway, figure out the stupid email problem, making a new account. Of course it's not. This is how I get to the developer page. Oh god, I don't know my password. I don't have one. But maybe I'm not on the right site. I'm not. Chat log and stats. Okay, I'm supposed to go to like docs. Chatbots. Yeah, they want you to use this. But I have a different chatbot. PHP one. I actually wanted to do this a long time ago. Integrate both of them. And have them database and talk to each other themselves through mysql. We're gonna need to copy this. Then don't mind what's going on here. We'll make a project folder. Of course, we'll have some issue. So this will be our client. What we need is, where are we going to go? The auth token. The thing is, for certain things like Steam, you have to generate your own auth token. You don't have a client ID. So So if you wanted it to opt into Google also and some other things. Like yeah, you would have to do some sort of really bad thing. Sure, that you'd just be doing a headache and then trying to pay a fortune. Because there's so much content on this that it's easy to get confused. Therefore, video component. For the OAuth, I think. Because in the docs. Twitch API. What do we have to do? So, if you need to know JS. You will have its package manager called NMP, it's like composer for JS. And then I did this. It'll get it here in a sec. gonna register this real quick. The auth token. Maybe an access token. So then we point it to our server. Just be like, we have to log into it. Tell it to. Test our callback, and later we figure out what code goes in there. And, test it if it remotely works like this. those two. Run the bot. Oh, we don't have a username. Surprise. So I have to Google something like get IRC Twitch password, and it gives you that bot. Yeah, it takes you to the generator. So this way you don't even have to do it like I'm trying to do it. And just have it so you can plug it in. So that's like my third password for the user. It makes it easier when you have it like this. So you're trying to do your apps. Some ID is some Twitch person's ID. Well, some Twitch person's ID matched up to a Steam ID. So therefore, it'd be like, say we wanted to give it to this person that made this. Usually it's this number, Steam 3 usually. Oh no, this thing. So I'm gonna go to my channel. That's great. Oh, this is something else compiled. An unexpected token. Tell you how to do this right. So in auto it's a bot for you. And then once it works, go into my show pop out Twitch chat. No GS language, okay, so next thing we need is the username from the event. Or new. None is coming out of that. once I modify it and I have to relaunch it, it reconnects. Good, I got the username. I didn't get the username. I got target. Target is this channel. A tutorial. Good. Okay, so I don't know. Probably a bad guess. Oh, it works, but I don't think it's the right way to do it. It is username and identity. You rolled a 1, you got a 10. And how come it's highlighted like that? That's crazy. Okay, but it is context, that username. So callback works. How would we need it for? For the here. Instead of this one. And make that the callback. Like write down the client's secret and the client ID somewhere else. side, like, got a client secret or something. So I could do the OAuth. Well, who cares? Someone hacks this application. What can I do with the OAuth? I actually know how to kind of do that crap. Got our database that we had made. And we've got a users. User main tools, user manager, add new user, TMI loader. Privileges to the set database, security reasons, and less headaches. So then we have the credentials. So we do view this. Establish the connection, I guess, in the beginning of the session. I'll be localhost. The user will be a user name litter thing guy. So when he rolls the dice, that's how I did it. So they do it. Just insert it live. Simulate this. Name would be the number. Let's run this again. Let's drop some dice in our channel, and it'll go into our game. Well, database, and then later we can make it go into a game also. Yes, and then we'll apparently get those. What if was my password wrong? What was the? What if I go? Some of it requires this manual labor testing. Really fun stuff. The user manager doesn't have a password change thing. Ah, here it is. This is my problem. Thank you. Okay. So if you're running a new version, you have to do that. I didn't know that yet, but I knew how to do it. Linux machine when you're locked out, like they were explaining over there, but this is something else now. It's not the password, maybe it's the local host. We could do this, I think. Just try it with a different type of user. And this one is for remote, one is for non-remote. That's what you need to. What is this? Yeah, it's confusing after a while. So that's our user. This MySQL connection issue thing is like the main thing for it to work. Okay, so what we did in the channel is change my database. Okay, we got some retard code. Cannot. I don't like how this message sounds. This is like, how do I throw this away? Shit. How do I dot release? That release. That's how he fetches everything. It already went into the rows by this point. So I'm gonna have to do the same thing next. Write a selector, an update, or another statement. So after you did the query, we need to release. Alright. Now let's bomb proof it. Set your spam. Okay. It's not a function. Using some pooling thing. I just want to straight up connect, reconnect. Just keep going. We don't throw the error, we just I got it in the wrong spot. To cancel the log there. Interesting. So I guess I had to implement an end function. Getting our loot. Five. Oh, more loot. Doesn't work. It's broken. Again. It'll do it for like the first time. Not the second time. That's a garbage. So, did that work? No. Determine insert. It used to insert. We know that it used to. This is what we need. Isn't like something. That's what we need to do. Put this here. This back. Shit, and now it works beautifully, I think. Yeah, so that die thing actually makes it disconnect. It's not an event. Whoops. We had 13, and now I have 25 loot. So, what it can also do, list the random users in the channel. There's a chat. There's an actual guide to this. so we need this type of data. Let's just get all the users in the channel and send them shit. This one IRC command, but they changed the commands on this shit. I made them all ghetto. All this shit. That would just be like a command. JS servers or something. And we can also connect it to Discord. This is my other stuff. Oh yeah, and then there's Pusher. Socket.io. So you first start out by resaving the bot and start to add stuff. To hard code the channel name, probably.
To the server list, so I'm gonna
so names is an unknown command. So how do we know the names? this is choosing the root. So you log into multiple channels. This is another bot. Credentials to us. Cool. Okay, function troll channel. Message.